Yeah. Okay, then, so there is some circuit element called gyrator. Gyrator, how can I write gyrator? Gyrator. Say, for example, say this is my gyrator. Gyrator looks like, the notation of gyrator looks like that. Say this is V1, I1, V2, I2. Okay, see if this is, there is some conductance G, then the gyrator characteristic is something like yeah, so my I1 is G times V2. My I2 is minus G times V1. Okay? So what does it look like? Oh, let's see. V1, V2. I1. Yeah. See, if I connect a capacitor here, say, I have a gyrator here. My gyrator. This is G. And then if I put a capacitor here, then it looks like an inductor there. Okay? Capacitor is changed to inductor. Say, yeah, let's try to find out. Yeah, so this is my V1, this is my I1, okay? And this is my I2, this is my V2, all right? This is a C. So my I2 is only SCV2, okay? But my I1 by gyrator, my I1 is only G times V2. Is it right? Oh, how come, where is my V1? I2 is, I have another equation, right? My I2 is minus G times V1. So what's V1 divided by I1? V1 is just V1. What's I1? Oh, GV2. What's V2? V2 is from here, one of SC. V2 is one of SC I2, right? What's I2? I2 is from here, GV2. I2 is V1 G times minus GV1 minus G of SC. Oh, looks like I don't like this. Let's see. This is only V1, right? Oh, I don't like this negative notation. Somehow I got something like that minus SC of GM square, right? But I have some negative sign. How come I have a negative polarity here? V2, I2. V2, I2. G. This negative polarity is a little bit weird, right? If I put this thing is a positive, this becomes a positive. Let me see. I will check. Okay. Then anyway, if this is a positive, this is S times L, right? So in the primary side, my inductor is only C of GM square. Okay. I must check this negative polarity. Okay, question. Nope. So this is my Xi data. This thing. Okay, let's just check the polarity, Xi data. So, yeah, this is my V1, this is my I1, this is my I2, this is my V2, right? So, let's just see. For this first transconductor G1, so this minus input is 0, positive input is V1, so it current flows out. So this current is 0, right? So this should be my I2. So this is the same as I2, right? This bottom transconductor, so you know the polarity is negative, right? It's different. And then the current flows in, GM2 V2 flows in, right? Oh yeah, it's a positive, should be positive. Okay, so I1 GM2, so this should be my I1. So in the previous Xi data, it was wrong. Say for this polarity, it's just something like that. Plus GM2, plus GM1, 0. V1, V2. Okay, so I put current flows in, flows out, then I should follow this notation. Okay, then, so here see, I know my I2 is only SC times V2, okay? Then, what's the relationship, this V1 and the I1? Yeah, I want to calculate V1 and the I1. And then, yeah, this I1 is GM2 V2, okay? Yeah. And then, what's the V2? Yeah, this V2 is, okay, by this equation, right? Then I will calculate the I2 by that equation. So this is GM2 of SC. I2 is GM1 V1, okay? So then this should be just SC of GM2, GM1, GM2, right? So here, see, I have inductance C of GM1, GM2. So I see inductance, grounded inductance, right? So here, see, my equivalent circuit is this V1, I1, and then I have a grounded inductor there, okay? In the GMC filter, the only element I can use is a transconductant capacitor, right? I want to make a resistor inductor by using only those transconductance C. Okay, question? No? Yeah, so next one, see, the purpose of this one is usually, let's just see, we have for the filter synthesis, so we have some transfer function, like what? Let's just see, where is my transfer function? Oh yeah. I have a third order filter here. Third order filter. This filter is a, is it Butterworth filter? Oh. I think this is a third order Butterworth Lopez filter. Yeah, this is a third order. So from this one, we can make a simple resistor circuit. Say for this one, I have something like that, something like that, something like that. So I have three energy storage element already. So this is passive prototype. So we will just, this passive prototype is available in the filter handbook. Then this passive prototype, so here see, this is very normalized, so it's omega zero is only 1 radian per second, right? This resistance may be just 1 ohm, 1 farad, 1 farad. I think this is 2 henry. This is 1 ohm. Is it 1 ohm? Yeah. So this is a passive prototype. So I want to convert, this C is easy, just a C. This R, we can make R. This grounded R is very easy. This floated R, there is some way. There is a floating inductor, right? So we want to implement a floating inductor by using transconductance C. We want to implement this floating resistor, actually source resistor, by using transconductor and C. Just transconductor. Let's see. Yeah, we need to see. This is a passive prototype. It's available. So if you derive a transfer function of VO over Vin, you can derive it. Let's see. Third order, right? Let me see. How does it look like? It's just something like. You can derive it rather easily. Yeah, this will be my transfer function. So here, see, if you substitute the RL, RS, and RL by 1 ohms, the DC gain is just 1/2, right? DC gain is 1/2. Yeah, because you use only, let's see. This omega zero thing, maybe, So this is 2, right? 2 ohm. And how about this? 1 ohm, 1 ohm, 2 henry, 1, 1, 1. So this is S cube times 2, right? So my omega zero is 1 radian per second. So it's normalized. So if I want to increase this omega zero to some maybe 10 kilohertz or something, so we can use scaling. And say, where is my scaling? Here. So this is my scaling. So I want to increase R from 1 ohm to 10 ohm, 10K ohm. Then my impedance scaling is 10 to the 4. Okay, if I want to increase my omega 0 from 1 radian per second to, for example, 1 megarad, 1 megahertz, yeah, 2 pi times megarad per second. This is just 1 megahertz, right? 1 megahertz. Then my frequency scaling is 2 pi times 10 to the 6, okay? Then I can adjust all those resistance multiplied by this IS, 10 to the 4. And then I multiply this inductor, IS divided by FS. And then capacitor just divided by IS times FS, right? Then we can scale the filter. Let's see. So this is multiplied by IS, right? Yeah, that's multiplied by IS. Yeah, it's multiplied by IS. How about this LP? Yeah, it's multiplied by IS and divided by FS. This S is actually what? S is multiplied by FS. Yeah, S is multiplied by FS. Okay. And then this thing is IS times this thing is divided by IS times capacitor FS, okay? Yeah, they are same, right? This is multiplied by FS, so it remains the same. This is multiplied by FS square. This is multiplied by IS. IS divided by FS something. This is IS. Is it IS? Yeah. And then this is divided by IS times FS. Then let's see. Oh, something wrong. I cannot scale exactly. IS. This is IS. IS is compensated there. And then this is not compensated. I have to check. This S square is FS square, right? Oh yeah, actually it's correct. Every terms are multiplied by just IS, right? This multiplied by IS. So I think you will check that scaling works. That scaling does not change this equation. This transfer function, okay? Question? Yeah, this scaling law does not change the transfer function, okay? No question? Yuan Chul, any question?